every single one of you guys for turning up today, because when you turned up today, you chose to be Shukri's voice. You chose to be Shukri's mom's voice, and you chose to stand against injustice.
Shukri Abdi passed away late June last month, 3 weeks ago now. The authorities want us to believe that this was a tragic death, that she drowned. But I'll tell you guys one thing for free. I will not let them insult my intelligence. And my mom did not raise no fool. Say it with me. No justice.
No peace.
No justice.
No peace.
Will you promise not to let this forgotten, not this, let this be forgotten, and make sure Shukri receives justice?
I will.
Will you promise to keep the momentum and put pressure on this institution?
I will.
Will you promise to embody the practice of kindness, empathy, and good that Shukri embodied to the end? Will you and make sure that she's rewarded in the afterlife?
I will.
Will you promise to stand up to bullies in whichever form they appear?
I will.
Will you stand up to this corrupt system that continues to fail us?
I will.
Thank you.
Question, as a parent myself, I want to know why my child died. And that is being not, that's been denied for the parents. And that's why, as the Somali community, we are here together. Because our sister, the mother of Shukri, may not know about the system and how it works, but we are tight-knit community, and come what may, we need to find out why she died. And unless that's answered, answer to us as parents, as British citizens, as British Somalis, we are not going to keep quiet. We are going to go all the way, come what may. Thank you.
The last couple of days we've got a really strong legal team behind us, and you know, so right now we've got directions and advice for every step we need to take. And yeah, and Zamzam has recently given a statement about the school bully and everything, so the police are adamant to tell us that the investigation is still going, even though they go on newspaper to say it isn't. But with the support and everything we've got, the event, I mean, this is not going to go quiet anytime soon. So,
why are you still protesting then? What are you calling
we're
for?
We're still protesting because we want to keep this story running. It has to be on people's minds. It has to be on the police officers' minds that try to dismiss it. On the school, they have to, you know, they have to feel the pressure of it, because this wasn't a small scale situation that happened. This was a really big situation that they tried to make it small, but now we are going to keep it big. You know.
And do you feel you're being treated with a bit more respect, because you felt that...
Yes, definitely, with me, yeah. And now we've got a legal team behind us, they have no choice but to show his respect. Because we've got people behind us and a community behind us, and you know, you can see right now the support we're getting. And this is everywhere. This is just a little bit of support today, but it's everywhere and it's loud.